Enjoy coming
on. I'm loving it.
Okay. It's our first time.
Yeah, in San Diego, yeah.
It's our first time here, so we're really excited.
It took me like 10 minutes to get over here.
I was just saying how it's so different than New York. Like, New York had the New York energy. This is like the laid back California energy.
Yeah. You're right.
Not as many costumes, too. Maybe it's because we haven't gone outside.
Yeah, you haven't been outside yet.
This is like the press section?
No, this is just like something that they do. When it first started,
I don't know that. Okay, well, I guess in New York it's more combined. Or here it feels almost separate.
You have to go to the convention.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I think I'm going to be there tomorrow.
Yes.
Okay, so we started to go.
Yes. Okay, are we going to the convention tonight?
So, yeah. I'm just super, super curious to know what's going on with your relationship on the show.
Right now, I think. Izzy and Simon are building a relationship as friends. I mean, they're really helping each other out. They haven't had a lot of time to, like, I think they're both on different paths. She's with the Shadowhunter, Simon's very much part of the down road. And the only Shadowhunter he really talks to is Clary, and that relationship will rock.
We're really good friends.
Yeah.
We've had a lot of cool moments that have already aired, and a lot of nice moments that are yet to come. But yeah, I mean, the relationship is there. It's just a friendship right now. It's you know,
but it's building a strong foundation, which I think is something that in order to build the proper ship that they want, needs to have a strong foundation.
They're taking him away from Izzy. Other girls are taking him away from
Izzy. So our site is LGBTQ, so I was actually wondering, since Raphael's asexual in the book, and they sort of started on that in the show, what was it like playing a character who's in a relationship, starting to be in a relationship with an asexual?
I mean, she didn't understand what it was. She had never been with somebody that was like that. So it was a character getting to know the way that it being like asexual doesn't mean you're gay. It just means that you don't have, you know, or some. It just depends. Like they feel love in a different way. They're more romantic. They believe in like a soulful connection instead of a physical connection.
One thing I think the show highlighted well was that. That doesn't mean you can't have a relationship. Relationships aren't based around sex. They're based around connection. And then sex comes from that connection, or it doesn't, but that's not what it's about. And I think you guys did that like really beautifully. That was like, okay, you guys both.
Yeah, I mean, like, I know that the writers, like, got together with, like, people that explained to them exactly how it is, what Raphael, how he explained to himself to Isabel, like, everything was seen by someone from that community to make sure they were representing it the right way.
I take that very seriously.
I'm sure you guys can't tell us a lot about what's coming up, but is there anything in the next couple episodes to close out season two that you're really excited for the fans to
see? Just announced that Sarah Hyland is playing the Sealy Queen, so that's going to be really, really awesome. She gets to do a lot of fun stuff with Simon.
So we could say that. We could say that these next four episodes, you see a huge journey for all of the Shadowhunters, and the way that story kind of unveils and what they're required to do as Shadowhunters, it's going to get really intense. Can we say more? Or should we leave it at that?
You know me. I tend to say more than what I should.
So I think we'll leave it at that. Just play safe. Play safe.
What is fan reaction to you guys? Like, do you have, like, is social media is kind of a whole different world these days? Do you interact a lot with people? Are you hearing from people? What are they saying most to you?
I feel that social media nowadays is kind of like having another job. I feel that it's our obligation to connect with our fans, to be there, to, you know, to interact with them. And it's also an immense, you know, platform to educate people and maybe motivate them to do, like, the right thing.
An immense responsibility we feel with it because of our reach, because of our fandom. It tends to be younger, and we want to perpetuate the way we want the world to change, not perpetuate the way it is or the way that it has been. We want to be like, no, you can be great. We should perpetuate love and positivity. The fan reaction has just been accepting. The fandom is very loving and positive and intelligent, and they seek out information, which is something that I think in the social media age, it's very cool now. It's not, you don't learn from one source. There's a million sources, and you get to kind of you get to kind of really find what you want, and our fans are very good at that. So we kind of perpetuate, keep learning for yourselves, keep pushing yourselves to new things, keep discovering new things.
You ever
very good at that.
Me?
Yeah, presenting like being like a strong woman.
Oh, I mean sometimes, but I mean you can't. It's inevitable. I'm a girl, and I like posting about girly stuff and about makeup and about how I look. But I think we all do, you know. I mean, it's normal. But yeah, I always tend. I just did a campaign with Orgullosa, which you know talks about the representation of Latina women. That not all Latinas are the same.
Yeah.
Different, and that people shouldn't like box us up in certain categories.
Yeah.
So, if there's one piece of advice you could give to your characters, what would it be?
Stop being kidnapped.
We were saying you should have, like, an ankle monitor.
Yeah, it should. They should have something that he could, like, a distress button. For, like, life alert. Like, yeah. You're kidnapped. No, just know that you're always where you're supposed to be. Whether it feels like it or not.
Probably tell Izzy to
chill. Girl, chill.